Operation Red Sea is a spiritual sequel to the film Operation Mekong. Both films are directed by Dante Lam. So Operation Mekong for me was a really solid movie. It's like a very intense, violent action movie. It's basically about Chinese special forces, the Navy going up against a drug lord in Thailand. And this movie, however, is a step down, I'd have to say. Both movies are the same length, but I felt that Operation Red Sea really dragged on. It's probably because the cast is different. There's no Eddie Peng, the other main character. He makes a small appearance, but this film is really scattered in terms of plot, story, characters, everything. This movie starts off with a brisk hostage rescuing scene. Somalian pirates have attacked a Chinese vessel, so the Navy goes in. And this opening sequence is very messy. I mean that in the sense that the cinematography changes every like 5 seconds. It'll switch to like a snorkel cam shot, and then shaky cam, then zoom in for no reason, and then like aerial shots. It's over-directed, I have to say that immediately. Also, there's no sense of geography. One of the characters announces that they have the hydraulics room and that they're keeping them back with like machine gun fire. And then they cut to the soldiers shooting a different guy. And then they don't even reference what happened to the first guy because he was wearing a very memorable jacket. So that guy, they just skip over that. They rescue the hostages, and then the real plot kicks in. There's a political coup happening in Yemen. So the Navy are sent in to rescue the Chinese consul and a bunch of Chinese citizens in a war zone. Their convoy is attacked by terrorists, really armed, well-organized terrorists, a little too organized. Anyways, there's an extended firefight. They get the bus out. The mission changes to stopping terrorists from achieving yellow cake. It's like a special chemical weapon that a journalist has been tracking. They get attacked in the desert, and then they have to go rescue more hostages and another Chinese citizen. So you can see the plot is all over the place. There's no main objective, right? The first movie was literally like Chinese Navy versus drug lord. The second film is like rescue these people, then rescue these people, then rescue these people, then rescue these people. And there's like sort of four acts. There's the opening, there's the opening rescue sequence, then there's the war zone, then there's the desert sequence, then there's the village. Okay, there's five acts. Then there's the village sequence, and then there's the ending sort of big boss sort of finale. So this movie is all over the place. It has a lot of bravado moments, you know, like the scenes where like the bad guy's gonna like shoot a bazooka, but the good guy shoots the bad guy and his bazooka misses, and you go, yeah! So there's a lot of those. I like those. I mean, I watch this movie because I want testosterone-fueled action sequences. I want bullets fired everywhere, and this movie delivers. There's a lot of cool shots of people running around with giant guns and assault rifles and bazookas, and they're all shooting each other's drones, lots of cool technology. There's like this machine you put on a door, and you can see who's behind the door because of heat signature. You get to see the Chinese Navy ship has an automatic gun that like takes out anti-aircraft. Like, fire is so awesome. Besides that, though, besides the action sequences and the violence, the movie has nothing else to offer. The characters are very threadbare. There's, like, the rookie. There's the two snipers that are probably the most entertaining. There's the female member. There's the guy who likes candy. There's the leader. There's the journalist. There's the terrorists. And there's, like, also a terrorist sniper that's a really good source of tension. But the movie can't really stop for character development because they keep moving on to the next mission and the story's all over the place. Sometimes I notice that the movie can get a little grating. It's not like the Wolf Warrior films where those movies are literally pure propaganda, essentially. This movie's a little bit more subtle with the whole how awesome the Chinese Navy is, but whenever they find a civilian who's injured or someone who's maimed and pretty much gonna die, they have to have a shot of the Chinese medic saving them because the Chinese Navy is so humanitarian. You know, in the middle of a firefight with terrorists, after a bus got bombed, they'll try to save people still. And then this happens like 4 times in the movie. I'm pretty sure they wouldn't do that in a real life, you know, life or death moment against terrorists, heavily armed with mortars and things like that. But the movie does, you know, try to paint the Chinese military in a really good light. It's not that much different from like a Michael Bay movie. However, besides the action sequences, the movie doesn't really have anything else to offer. The smaller characters like the journalist and the soldiers, they don't really have much to do. So if you want just action sequences, you'll get that, but don't expect Operation Mekong. That movie is way superior, probably because Eddie Peng has a lot of charisma. This movie, no one stands out in this movie. And those are my thoughts on Operation Red Sea. I give it a 6.5 out of 10.